Hello and welcome to another edition of We Stream. Today we're going to be checking out Bo Burnham, Welcome to the Internet, from his special Inside. I haven't watched this special yet. I was like, I'll get to it eventually. I never have time to watch anything I want to watch. But lo and behold, Mr. Burnham put part of it on YouTube, which means I could at least watch this part of the special. I'll watch the entire thing at some point, I'm sure. But now I get to watch a bit of the special. And if you don't know who Bo Burnham is, I'm not going to explain who Bo Burnham is, because the anti-intellectual, anti-humor rocks you dwell under are not of my concern to try to fix. If you don't know who Bo is, you either too young or too uncultured for me to go down that path. You can figure it out yourself. For the rest of us, I am going to try to get in as much of a mood as I can to appreciate the insanity that we're probably going to be given here, with a ton of nuance, really deep things, and some funny lols mixed in, as Bo Burnham likes to do. So let's just see what this is. Bo Burnham Inside, or Bo Burnham Welcome to the Internet, from his Netflix special Inside, which he filmed during the pandemic alone in his room, true to old Bo Burnham YouTube style.
Welcome to the Internet.
Have a look around. Anything that brain of yours can think of can be found.
A very interesting carnival thing. Welcome to the Internet with a doot-doot-doot-doot. I think there's a little bit of interesting weird thing going on with the voice. I don't know if it's the type of pitch correction he's using or something. There's just an interesting gargle in it.
We've got mountains of content, some better, some worse. If none of it's of interest to you, you'd be the first.
If you don't like anything on the Internet, you're the first one. There's something for everybody. This is Menace. The foot obsession of the Internet is very odd. People who like feet. I try not to kink shame on my channel, but just keep that to yourself, you know?
There's no need to panic. This isn't a test. Just nod or shake your head and we'll do the rest.
Who's we? Are you part of some Internet evil tribe?
Welcome to the Internet.
Oh, this is a dark carnival evil vibes abound.
What would you prefer? Would you like to fight for civil rights or tweet a racial slur?
See, Welcome to the Internet is really Welcome to Civilization, just a little more unhinged and unfiltered, because people tend to have a little more restraint in public areas than they do online. He's just like, what do you want? You want to fight for civil rights or you want to be racist, eh?
Be happy, be horny, be bursting with rage.
Whatever you want, the Internet will have a page for you, right? You could rhyme that with rage. I don't know what Bo's about.
We got a million different ways to engage.
Ooh, engage. That's a fancy rhyme. Yeah, I mean, there's a page on the Internet for every mood and occasion. I feel like by the end of this song, Bo's gonna try to make me depressed about life.
Welcome to the Internet. Each other, welcome to the Internet.
A bunch of colored pencil chalks. I'm all scared. Like, I was just laughing. He's like, welcome to the Internet. Here's Harry Potter characters fucking. We talked about Rule 34 stuff on our last reaction that had to do with Sonic the Hedgehog and its fandom.
Hold on to your socks, because a random guy just kindly sent you photos of his cock.
Guys, don't do that. Nobody wants to see Dingle unless they asked to see Dingle. Nobody looks at unsolicited Dingle and suddenly goes, oh, I must have you. That's not how it works. No matter how glorious you think your Dingle may be. Of course, that's not the whole thing. That's not the purpose. People who are sending their Doingle aren't thinking that you're suddenly going to want to jump on the Doingle. It's voyeurism. It's another kink, just one that's a little too intrusive on other people. And we can kink shame kinks that happen to violate other people's privacy and rights. And voyeurism's one of them. Naughty, naughty.
They are grainy and off-putting. He just sent you more. Don't act surprised. You know you like it, you whore.
Ah, well, you know. Some people into those things. But if you don't send it to the right person. The increase of tempo is making me anxious.
See a man beheaded, get offended, see a shrink. Show us pictures of your children, tell us every thought you think.
All right, so yeah, we're getting more and more maniacal. So he's like, you know, here's some see someone that gets their head cut off. You didn't want to see that. Now you're offended. You see a shrink to recover from the shit you weren't supposed to see in your life. And, you know, all of your data is sold online to everybody. Everybody gets your data. Yay, this song's getting increasingly more depressing like I thought. And we'll get the little bits of ha-ha humor, but this is Bo Burnham. This is modern Bo. There was a younger Bo that was more lulz and less, life is bad. But older Bo has been more, I'm going to make you embrace reality and chuckle about it, which I am here for.
Start a rumor, buy a broomer, send a death threat to a boomer, or DM a girl and groomer, do a zoomer, find a tumor and...
God, hold on. So we have death threats to boomers, doing stuff on Zoom calls, grooming underage girls, or of-age girls.
Buy a broomer, send a death threat to a boomer, or DM a girl and groomer, do a zoomer, find a tumor in your... Here's a healthy...
Find a tumor? Oh, God. Someone was on WebMD. Oh, God. This is what happens if you go on internet forums. Here's a healthy breakfast. Kill your mom. You know how many shootings and shit, especially in younger kids, have been, like, linked back to fucking dudes not getting laid and then just killing the world? Bro. Suck off a weirdo, save a life, I guess.
Which Power Ranger are you? Take this quirky quiz. Obama sent the immigrants to vaccinate your kids.
He sent the immigrants to do it?
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine, but you just can't get in.
This just is like the chaos of the internet that, like, you know, being a member of the internet as my occupation. If you follow me on Twitter, you see me just posting stuff decently often, just going, why? Why, internet? Why are people so stupid and so vocal about it?
Could I interest you in everything all of the time? A little bit of everything all of the time.
Yeah, I mean, once you give someone everything all the time, which is the internet, you get numb. You gotta pace yourself. You know, I try to do a lot of offline work throughout my day and detach. But what's crazy is I'm an internet personality at this point as a big part of my job. And yet I know I spend less time on my phone and on the internet than some of the people I know who have, like, day jobs. And I'm like, you gotta step away, because once you have everything all the time, like, your dopamine gets all fucked up. Everything becomes numb and apathetic and grayed together, and you become zombie people. Luckily, when you meet people in the real world, most of the time they de-zombify if they could put their phone down. But these other people that stay zombified, they go crazy and then they start killing each other. And it's not good. It's not the internet's fault. It's people not putting it down's fault. But I digress.
Apathy's a tragedy and boredom is a crime.
Hey, apathy's a tragedy. Boredom is a crime. I was just talking about apathy. You see, Bo and I, we understand.
Anything and everything all of the time.
Hold on, what are you?
He's a tragedy and boredom is a crime. Anything and everything all of the time.
Yeah, everything and anything all of the time. It's not healthy. It's stimulant overload. Our brains were not designed for it, and it would take thousands of years of evolution for our brains to adapt to the internet. So you gotta pace yourself on your own, because your brain's not gonna do it for you.
And could I interest you in everything all of the time? A little bit of everything all of the time.
Such a happy little tune for such misery.
Apathy's a tragedy and boredom is a crime. Anything and everything all of the time.
Uh-oh. We've changed the lighting. You gotta appreciate that Bo has, like, the camera zooms and zoom ins and zooms outs and crap when he did this all on his own in his room. Attention to detail to make it feel more like a production.
Time.
Not before my time. When I was a young lad, there was no internet. Try to raise your kids as if there was no internet when they were young lads as much as possible.
Right behind.
He's talking about, like, that millennial shift. The millennials know this shift. Well, the older millennials. Before 9/11, you know, how people were all chill. But really, though, were we? Most decades and stuff, there was a bunch of angry stuff in the papers and everything. It's just, it got so much more saturated with the internet and so much more in your face. But people have always been people. Everything sucked. But what's weird is if you do look at the 90s and even most of the 80s, they're kind of isolated from the rest of history in that most people didn't care about any shit that was happening. You didn't have major civil rights movements. You didn't have the hippie movements. You just had people like wearing goofy clothes and having a good time for like two solid decades almost. Then the World Trade Center went down. We went back to the same shit that we had in the 70s, 60s, and then all the rest of the world. But I remember I used to use the internet pretty much exclusively for AOL Instant Messenger to talk to people who I knew in real life. I didn't go in the creepy chat rooms that a lot of people did. I went in like once and I was like, this is weird. And so I just talked to people I knew. George Tankian or somebody making a rock metal version of this. Now I just kind of want that in my life. And now I'm even more sad. I'm sad about the reality of the song, the fact that, you know, most of us are powerless to try to influence people to take breaks from the internet and not fuck up all the chemicals in their brains. But then also sad that I want to hear this song as a metal song and I can't. It was truly disturbing, and you know, any outro commentary would just seem inappropriate at this point. So until next time, Ice Scheme, You Scheme, We All Scheme for Ice Cream. Bye, I guess.